Near the end of the Second World War, Italy surrendered, which led to the Germans occupying Italy to prevent the Allies from making an invasion from the south. This led to horrific fighting, as well as the Germans brutally oppressing the Italian population, which had originally been their allies. What took place in the Second World War is partly what inspired the Italian neorealist movement. The war left very little resources, especially for filmmaking, and so filmmakers like Vittorio De Sica started a movement in film styles where films were shot on location with tiny budgets and non-professional actors. A prime example would be De Sica's Bicycle Thieves, which is still regarded as a classic today. The neorealist movement attempted to portray the common man struggling in a post-war economy, though a number of these films dealt with the war itself. The first international success for Italian neorealism would be Roberto Rossellini's Rome Open City. Loosely based on true stories, Rome Open City is about the occupation of Italy by the Germans, as well as those in the resistance movement trying to undermine them. Due to having almost no money for production, as well as having almost no way to actually cut and edit the film properly, the quality of Rome Open City has maintained a very grainy look. It's led people to call it more of a documentary than a feature film, but either way, there is no denying the authenticity of the film. The story follows two resistance fighters, their families, their enemies, and a Catholic priest who is surprisingly their most valuable friend. Manfredi is a marked man, already a legendary resistance fighter. His comrade, Francesco, is a printer and is engaged to marry a single mother who is already pregnant with their child. Pina is a determined young woman trying to raise her son during the occupation, even as he joins a group of other children to form a resistance movement of their own. The children are also under the watchful supervision of Don Pietro, a priest who is actively helping the men of the resistance despite their communist sympathies and atheism. The two villains of the film are Major Bergman and his spy Ingrid, and they're portrayed as unnatural caricatures of ordinary people. Of course, since this movie was made in the mid-40s, and because Rossellini was a religious man, the unnaturalness is translated to their implied homosexuality. Bergman is a ruthless but clearly effeminate man, and Ingrid is a vicious seductress who lures women to her side with gifts and promises of drugs. In cases like this, it's just better to chalk this off as being a film of its time. The film was made at a terrible time for Italy, and so there's a desire by Rossellini and his screenwriters to convey the brutality as much as they could, while also providing hope for the future. One of the main issues is the unlikely alliance between left-leaning rebels and the Catholic Church. There's a subtle tension between the priest and the resistance fighters, but they're ultimately united in their struggle against the fascists. Don Pietro is confronted with the fact that without the war, he would be an enemy to his communist friends. But he comes to a conclusion that makes for one of the film's best lines. For all this film's authenticity, great writing, excellent drama, and fleshed-out protagonists, there are some flaws to watching it nowadays. Only about two-thirds of the lines are given subtitles, and as I said before, the two main antagonists are stereotyped in a way that would be considered insulting by our standards. What manages to endure is the strength of the messages in the film, as well as the powerful moments brought out through the actors' performances. Hopelessness is conveyed very well by people whose country was still being fought over, but the nobility of the resistance leads us to think that there is hope for a better future, and that it's worth fighting for. Rome Open City holds up very well for a movie that was made in 1945. It serves as a time capsule, maintaining philosophies and ideas of an earlier time. It kickstarted the global appeal for Italian neorealism, it would go on to help inspire the French New Wave in the 60s, and it propelled the careers of those involved. On that note, one of the screenwriters for this film was a very young Federico Fellini, whose name is often listed amongst the greatest directors of all time. Rome, Open City was the first Oscar nomination he would receive in his life. He would be nominated for 11 more throughout his career.